All right, guys, today we will talk about scientific notation like we did last time. So we use scientific notation for very, very big numbers or very, very small numbers. Right. How wide is our universe? Is there anyone, guys, can reach these huge numbers? There is no way, right? And so with the help of guys, scientific notation, we can read it. This number written is decimal notation. You can say decimal notation or standard form. Some textbooks use decimal notation for these huge numbers, or they use standard form. When numbers get this large, it is easier to write them in scientific notation, right? So today, this is what we are going to learn. Now, here is the guys to format. Here's the format. A number is expressed in scientific notation when it is in the form A times 10 to the power of N. And A must be the number before the decimal must be between 1 and 10. That is the key point. That's the key point. That A is between 1 and 10, and N is an integer. N is an integer, all right? So this is the rule. Imagine, guys, centuries ago, mathematicians got together to find a solution how we can read these huge numbers. So they find the format. This is the format. This is the format. A times 10 to the power of N. The thing is, the number before the decimal must be between 1 and 10. So what are those numbers, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. It cannot be greater than 10. It cannot be less than 1. It must be single digit, right? Between 1 and 10. Now, so let's rewrite this one. There are a lot of rules you should remember, but we are now using our calculator. You don't have to, guys. You don't have to memorize any rules. Can you guys please mute your phone? All right, so this one is, you see that? This decimal is right here. Why we put this decimal here? Because this number before the decimal must be between 1 and 10. Can I put this decimal right next to the 1? No, if I put the decimal right here, it will be 21, and 21 is not between 1 and 10, right? So I cannot put this decimal right next to the 1. It should be between 2 and 1. The reason is the digit before the decimal must be between 1 and 10. That is the rule. Yes, Kylie. Okay. Now, when the original number is more than 1, the exponent is positive. You see that? What is the exponent scientific notation here? 2.1 times 10 to the power of 23. As you see, guys, in here, this huge number now can be written as 2.1 times 10 to the power of 23, which is extremely, guys, easy to read. But there is no way to read this huge number, right, actually. But if you change it to scientific notation, it is a lot easier, right? So 2.1 times 10 to the power of 23. All right. Now, how about this one? 0.000009 also. Do you think this one is in scientific notation? Amir, do you think this one is in scientific notation? This one? No. Because this digit 0, and it's a single digit, that's correct, but it is not between 1 and 10. It must be 1 and 10. Where I'm supposed to move it until I get a number which is between 1 and 10. So where is it? It is here, because 9 is between 1 and 10. But how many zeros we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. I will put this one on the guys, the website. 0.0123456 and 7, 9 or can calculate it. Let me see. It wants me. Okay, I add zero. I don't want to add anything. So what is the answer? 9.02 times 10 to the power of 8. You see that? 9.02 times 10 to the power of 8 is the answer. So what is the guys the digit before the decimal? 9. Is it between 1 and 10? Yes. So 9.02 times 10 to the power of negative 8. Let me make it bigger so you can see easier. Guys, I changed this one to, I can change this one to any operation, but this is the only numbers. This is the only number, and I don't want to add anything. So therefore, I put zero in here, zero in here. I put addition in here. If I add any number to zero, it will be itself. It's not going to change anything, all right? So the last time we had trouble when we divide them, right? So therefore, I found this website for you. So this let you do any operation you want, addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. I have only one number in here, 0.0000902. So when you guys go back to the website here, you just put the number in here, and there is no second number. There is no second number. Therefore, I put zero in here, and I put the addition sign, right? And because any number plus zero is itself. It is not going to add anything to the number. Zero is, guys, nothing. All right. So now, so I got on the website 9.02 times 10 to the power of negative 8. You see that? It is the same thing in here. 9.02 times 10 to the power of negative 8. Right? So now, this is the answer, right? Here, this is in scientific notation. Okay, and how about this one? 28,750.9. So let me put this one in my website, or you can use guys your calculator. And so the thing is, guys, to be able to use your calculator, you have to put the number first. 27.50.9, and then hit enter, and then don't forget to hit second, then right next to the second, you will see VRG. On top of VRG, you will see SPI. SPI means the scientific notation. Use the arrow to go to the next, the middle one is scientific notation. And then I hit enter. It gives me the answer in scientific notation. It says 2.87509 times 10 to the power of 4. I will put this one on my website. What if you do not have a calculator at all? Put this one and second number will be zero and hit calculate. And you see that I got the same thing on my calculator. 2.87509 times 10 to the power of 4. Which one is the answer? The power is 4, 2.87509. That is the answer. So the answer is 3. You see that? Is it hard? Is it hard, guys? Ella, is it hard? No, all right, thank you. And guys, please turn on your camera if you can. This one, 1.8 times 10 to the power of negative 4, okay. This time we will write this one in decimal notation. Guys, decimal notation, there's another name for that. Decimal notation is exactly the same as other name is standard form. There are two names. Some textbook use decimal notation, some textbook use standard form. All right, standard form. There are two guys' names for that. Don't forget. Now, okay, so 1.8, Jana, 1.8 times 10 to the power of negative 4, 1.8 times 10 to the power of, this is the power, negative 4, you said, this is in scientific notation, and this one was already in scientific notation, right? Where is the standard for? I couldn't find it, right? I couldn't find it. Where is this guy, the standard for? So what you can do is, what you can do is for this one, we can go to, we can go to Google. So let me copy this link. All right, I will paste it in here. All right, scientific calculators. And 1 second. Yes, you can do this one, scientific notation calculator. And it is this one, calculatorstool.com. Okay, you can put this number here. What was the number? I will share you two links then. I will share you two links. If there are more than one number, use the first one. If there are more than two, if there are more than two numbers, use the first one. But if there are only one number, need to change and use the second one. Okay. And I will also share these two links on Google Classroom, all right? On Google Classroom. And let me copy this number from here and paste it in here. This one let you guys, this one let you get the answer in standard form. You see that this is the standard form, or you can say decimal or a notation. Decimal notation and decimal notation and standard form is exactly the same thing. The only problem is some textbooks use guys decimal notation, the others are used in standard form, right? So these are the two same things. Okay. Now the answer is 0.0018. What we got on our website, 0.0018. That's okay. What about 458 times 10 to the power of 6? Let's change this one to decimal notation. Okay. What is the number 458 times 10 to the power of 6? 4.58 times 10 to the power. How we can make power? Shift. Shift six and 10 to the power of 6. What is the answer? This is the answer. This is in standard form. This is in scientific notation. All right. So this is what I'm looking for. 40,580,000. And what about here? Yes, we got the same. Now, on the graphing calculator, scientific notation is done with guys. DRG, don't forget this one. This exponent button is old version of it, and don't forget. Who wants to guys tell me when we guys do division? When we guys do division, we should be careful with something. What is that? We shouldn't forget to put something on our calculator, otherwise we would get something wrong. What is that? Do you remember?
Parentheses.
Who said it?
Me, Musa.
Is it you, Kia?
No, Musa.
Okay, that's absolutely correct. Don't forget to guys put a parenthesis if you are guys dealing with scientific notation. And look at here, guys. Look at here. I will show you something. 20 times 4 divided by 20 times 2. What is 20 times 4? What is 20 times 4? 80. What is 20 times 2? 40. What is 8 divided by 40? 2. Guys, can you please put this one on your calculator? Can you please put this one on your calculator? 20 times 4 over 20 times 2. Can you put exactly the same thing on your calculator? Do you have a calculator? Do you have a calculator? Yes. I mean, if you have guys, Ella, thank you. Thank you, Ruta. If you have one guy, can you please use a calculator? And to get the answer, can you also please tell me what you got? 20 times 4 over 20 times 2.
I got 8.
You got 8. But Who else? One more person. Yes, Italy. Thank you. It is eight. It is eight. But why we got two? Why we got two? What is wrong? What is wrong in here? Ladies and gentlemen, the correct answer is two. It is not eight. It is not eight. So the problem is in here. We have two numbers as a denominator. If you have more than one number, you always need to put a parenthesis. Amir, can you try one more time? Italia, can you try one more time? What if you put them in a parenthesis? What you will get? What you will get?
I got two.
You got two now. You see that how important guys to use, how important to use guys parentheses, all right? Don't forget to use, yes, Italia, let me see what you got. Yes, two this time. Why? Because we have two numbers. 20 is the first number and 2 is the second number as a denominator. If we have two numbers as a denominator, you have to put them in a parenthesis. Otherwise, it will be wrong. The same thing in here. 1.6 is a number, and the other number is 10 to the power of negative 2. Scientific notation is a lot easier than the exponent with the calculator. But addition, multiplication, subtraction is so easy. But when it comes to the division, you should always use a parenthesis. All right? So put them in a parenthesis, you will get the right answer now. Right? You will get the right answer. What is it will be now? You must include parentheses. Don't forget. And we check it one last time, right? This is not 5, it's negative 2, right? This is negative 2. And you see that, guys? I use a parenthesis in here. You see this one parenthesis? You see this one? I put them in a parenthesis. Whenever I use a calculator, I always, guys, use a parenthesis in division. Okay. Now the answer is 0.028125. This is in tenth form, but if I want to change it to scientific notation, don't forget to use second and DRG, then use the arrow, then go to scientific notation. It will be 2.8125 times 10 to the power of negative 3. Okay. Now, how about this one, guys, this one on our website, 4.5 times. Which website I will use? Am I going to use this website or the other one? Which website I will use, guys? Can I use this one? But it is just letting me to use only one number, right? So I cannot use. Which website I will use? This one. Why? Because I hit two numbers. What was the number? 4.5. Let me see. 4.5 times 10 to the power of 10 to the power of negative 5. What operation I am doing? Division. But I have to put them in a parenthesis. And then the second number is 1.6 times 10 to the power of negative 2. Then don't forget to put them in a parenthesis because it is division. But if you do addition, subtraction, or multiplication, you don't have to use the parenthesis. And the calculator. So the answer is here. 2.8125 times 10 to the power of negative 2. This one. If you want to change this answer to standard form, I copy this one, I go to the another website and copy it in here, calculate it. And so this is to the power, I forgot the power, or it didn't copy, I think. You see that it is in standard form now. Okay, 0.028125, and science notation is 2.8125 times 10 to the power of negative 3. You see that we have both of them. This is a standard notation. This is the science notation. Guys, is it getting better? Is it getting better? Let me ask from the order. Amir, any question? Ruta. All right, Ella. Any question, Ella? No. Jana, how is it now, Jana? Jana, are you there? Oh, Jana checked me. Okay. We will do more exercise, Jana. All right. And guys, here, this is division. For divisions, we always try to put them in the parentheses. If you have a calculator, this is extremely easy for you. And you will just use a second and DRG and you need to click time, SCI, that means the scientific notation in here. And you need to guys click on second in here. Then right next to the second, you will see DRG. And then you will be given three options. Three options, okay? So you need to use scientific notation, the middle one. The first one, flow, means it standard notation. Standard notation, standard form, right? So, but the second one is scientific notation. There are three options, you see that? Flow, scientific notation, and ENG. ENG means that guy, an engineer, he will not use it. Now, let's copy this one on our calculator. And I need two numbers, so I will use this website, not the other one. I also share these two websites with you. 7.2 times 10 to the power of -9, shift 6 will give me the exponent. And I need to put them in a parenthesis. And open the parenthesis and close it in the middle of the parenthesis. What I need to put 1.2 times 10 to the power of 2.
You put -6 instead of -9.
7.2 times 10 to the power of 9. Oh, thank you. Who is that? I love you. Thank you. So the answer.
Wait, what's this website called? The
website, calculatorsoup.com. The problem is, I didn't put a parenthesis. Let me put a parenthesis. Okay. Oh, I got the same thing. Oh, on a website, it is not important to put a parenthesis, but on your calculator, it is extremely important. All right. Why I do not use this one? Because it just let me use one number. Look. If I want to divide them, it is not going to let me. Look, what's going to happen now? Just watch. Okay, look. It gives me, guys, the error. Then I click on this one. Scientific notation calculator. You see, it's an error, right? I click on this. So you see that it is giving me two options now. All right? 1.2, so you can copy those numbers now. 7.2 in here. And second, first number is here. All right. So here is the answer. This is scientific notation, right? All right. So this is pretty much of it, guys. But if you want to change it, want to standard form, yes, you need to go back to the other website. And put this one in here, and it will give you the answers in standard form. So now, guys, tomorrow you will get your 5-week report card, and please do your Khan Academy assignment. And I put you guys in a different classes. So you had an email, you got an email. It is about Khan Academy. I am asking you to join that specific class, like either 8-1 or 8-2 or 8-3. Please join that class to be able to see your assignment. All right? So you need to guys open your Gmail account and see Khan Academy mass email. I ask you to join that class. Some of you still didn't join, guys. If you do not join, you will not be able to see the guys' assignment. Please finish all the assignments you are given. And today, after this credit, I will guys submit the
program. Can you put a link in the chat?
Okay. And so many of you guys finish all of it, and your grade already. And many of you guys got 100. Please, guys,
Mr. Dervis.
Yes, sir. Yes.